The University of North Texas Brass Band performing Philip Sparks' Dundonald from Hymn of the Highlands back in March. Shortly after that performance, the university had spring break, and I returned to the UK to co-present the brass final of the BBC Young Musician of the Year, give a recital and masterclass at the Royal Welsh College of Music and Drama, and play a concert with Roger Argente's amazing Super Brass Ensemble. At that time, little did I know it would be the last live concert I'd be part of in 2020. Back then, I guess none of us really knew the severity of what was around the corner. But as the world went into lockdown, musicians and organisations found ways to continue making music. And during this Reflections concert, I'll be sharing with you some of the projects I've been involved in. A first for me was when Buffet Crampon, who make the best euphonium I play, invited me to give a recital live streamed from my living room. The full performance, billed as Together at Home, can be seen via the Buffet Crampon Paris Showroom Facebook page listed in the description below. Although it was a very unique experience, one of my favourite moments from the evening was being joined remotely by pianist Chris Williams and my father Robert Childs for a performance of Sir Edward Elgar's Salut d'Amour. Piece of music, and great to see my dad playing his gold-plated Besson euphonium too. I was a member of the National Youth Brass Band of Great Britain, so it's always a great pleasure to return as a tutor, but this year it was a particular honour to accept Bramwell Tovey's invitation to be the band's guest soloist for the first ever virtual course, National Youth at Home. At this point, the days of turning up, performing, then going home were firmly behind us. So for me, it really was a guest appearance like no other. Once repertoire had been agreed, the task of creating guide tracks, distributing music, collecting videos and editing everything together began. It was very much a learning process for me, and although it was a great pleasure to collaborate with the young musicians in this way, the highlight was definitely the music we played. A link to the full National Youth at Home concert is listed in the description below, but for now I'm joined by members of the National Youth Brass Band of Great Britain and Bramwell Tovey for The Better World, presented in memory of its composer Norman Bearcroft. Thank you.
Thank you.
Aside from teaching and playing, many of you will know that I'm passionate about brass bands and take great delight in being the editor of the Brass Band World magazine. In this capacity, I have the opportunity to learn about the many banding activities that take place throughout the world. And on occasion, I also get the chance to interview fellow musicians. During this past year, I've been able to catch up with Christian Lindberg, Dame Evelyn Glennie, Joseph Alessi, and some fantastic bandsmen too, like Ian Porthouse, Gary Curtin, and Tom Hutchinson. However, the real driving force behind the publication is its managing and editorial director, Nikki Bland. Due to international travel restrictions, Nikki was unable to attend her son's wedding earlier this year, but came up with the idea of a musical gift that could be sent to the newlyweds on their wedding day. I was delighted to help with this, and together with my sister Lisa, brother-in-law Ollie, wife Joanne, and a green screen, we recorded this bespoke wedding performance of Ennio Morricone's theme from The Mission, Gabriel's Oboe. Thank you. COVID restrictions have meant that large ensembles such as brass bands and orchestras have been unable to meet and perform in person. However, throughout the world, we've seen great innovation from groups joining together, creating their own online lockdown performances. The early contributions created by our top brass bands and orchestras really were quite stunning and inspired many of us to have a go ourselves. This next item was one of the first video projects I attempted in 2020 and once again features the University of North Texas Brass Band, this time in a socially distanced performance of Dan Price's Starburst. Thank you. year, I have the pleasure of tutoring the euphoniums and baritones of the Brass Band Summer School, a six-day band camp for brass band instrumentalists of all ages and abilities. During the course, the tutors provide the evening entertainment through a variety of recitals, and despite this year's virtual format, that tradition continued. It was great to see Les Niche perform a recital with Becky Smith and to hear Owen Farr team up with Brian Taylor, and it was my pleasure to share a recital with James Fountain, the London Philharmonic Orchestra's principal trumpet. Together with his girlfriend, Lucy Murphy, on piano, James was stunning, and through the power of technology, it was an honour to join the couple in their living room for a performance of this duet by Ben Hollings, entitled Novella. Playing from James, who comes from a very musical family and recently recorded some fantastic trios with his brother and father, which can be viewed via the WobPlay platform. A link is included in the description below. During this year's unique Brass Band Summer School, the course featured online coaching sessions, masterclasses, webinars, Q&As, lessons, and virtual rehearsal performances. However, one of the highlights was definitely the finale concert. Seeing all the delegates together on the screen under the musical direction of Richard Evans was quite special. Once again, the whole concert can be viewed by following the link in the description below, but here is a performance of Pastime with Good Company featuring the full band, followed by Reverend Archie Beaton, performed by the Tutors.
Thank you.
to Brian Taylor and James Fountain on cornets, Owen Farr on horn, Becky Smith on trombone, Les Niche on tuba, and Simone Ribello on vibraphone. I look forward to performing with them again and working with more delegates at the next Brass Band Summer School from the 8th to the 14th of August 2021. With Zoom's meteoric rise in popularity, the world has certainly become a smaller place. As euphonium professor at the University of North Texas, I've been able to invite international guests for masterclasses and Q&As with my students. And likewise, it's been a pleasure for me to make virtual appearances at many festivals, band camps, band rooms, and universities too. During 1 week, I began my virtual schedule in New York for the Star Lake Music Camp before zooming to the Amersham Band Room in the UK, then back to the USA for the National Youth Brass Band of America, on to James Madison University for a quick Q&A, finishing in Canada for an appearance at the Hannaford Youth's virtual band camp. Here's a little solo Chris Williams and I played for the Hannaford Youth Band during my masterclass. It's one I'm sure many of you will know, the Carnival of Venice. Thank you. Carnival's a great solo to demonstrate various parts of technique, but I believe the euphonium is at its best when playing in a cantabile style. So I was delighted when Professor Michael Alcorn invited me to perform one of my favourite lyrical solos with his Belfast-based Downshire Brass. I started my doctorate under Michael's mentorship at Queen's University Belfast back in 2015, so it was wonderful to reconnect with him for the band's brilliant virtual concert, all of which Michael produced and edited himself. The full concert, together with other performances from Downshire Brass, is listed in the description below, but here we are performing Sir Carl Jenkins' beautiful Benedictus. Thank you. Music by Sir Carl Jenkins, and congratulations to Downshire Brass, who went on to win their division of the Corey Online Brass Band Championships a couple of months later, with a fantastically innovative programme once again put together by Professor Michael Alcorn. Last year, I had the pleasure of recording Edward Gregson's Euphonium Concerto with the BBC Philharmonic Orchestra and joined London Brass for a few tracks on the composer's Music of the Angels CD, released earlier this year to celebrate his 75th birthday. Unfortunately, many performances celebrating the music of Edward Gregson were cancelled this year, but the University of North Texas Brass Band paid tribute to him back in March with a performance of his Prelude for an Occasion, and I was able to give a virtual premiere of his Euphonium Concerto in its piano reduction form at the International Euphonium and Tuba Festival hosted in Atlanta. Here's the finale from Edward Gregson's brilliant concerto, A Celtic Bacchanal. University of North Texas Euphonium and Tuba Studios have joined together for a Halloween concert, a tradition started by my predecessor, Dr. Brian Bowman. The annual concert entitled Tubaween is usually a lot of fun, and this year was no different, with some inventive contributions from the students, a couple of new compositions, and even a cameo appearance by a brass band celebrity narrator. However, it was composer Ben Hollings that provided a beautiful moment of reflection during the concert, demonstrating the wonderful sound of low brass to great effect. The University of North Texas Tuba Euphonium Ensemble and myself dedicate this virtual performance to lost loved ones and those who continue to battle through these difficult times. This is the spirit within. link to UNT's full Tubuin concert is listed in the description below. But now we continue with something very different. Last year, I had the pleasure of directing the Dallas Brass Band in a concert entitled Christmas with the Salvation Army. As you might have guessed, this year's concert was an online virtual event, which I once again enjoyed being part of. However, I've chosen to feature something from last year's live event, during which the band was joined by the Dallas Symphony's Elmer Charampi. Several of Elmer's performances with Dallas Brass Band are listed in the description below, but this one sees him join forces with members of the band for a festive take on Leroy Anderson's Bugler's Holiday. Item of this Reflections concert is a special piece for me, and during these challenging times its title alone may be poignant for many. The music was played at the christening of both my sons, Ben and Sam, and also the christening of my niece and nephew, Hannah and Matthew. The church where they were christened not only provides the backdrop for this virtual performance, but it's also the church where my wife and I were married. Yesterday we celebrated our 14th wedding anniversary, and today I'd like to dedicate this performance to my wife, Joanne. Featuring a small group from the National Youth Brass Band of Great Britain and composed by Sir Carl Jenkins, this is the song, I'll Make Music. We've reached the final item of this New Year's Eve concert, but before the curtain comes down, I'd like to thank everyone who has contributed to the performances you've just seen and the one that you're about to see. We end with excerpts from Tchaikovsky's 1812 overture in an arrangement featuring the brass band's summer school delegates, tutors, and some special guests, including Philip Cobb, Tom Hutchinson, Chris Turner, John Barber, Robert Childs, and James Gourlay. If you're anything like me, the usual optimism surrounding a new year may be struggling to surface right now, but as the saying goes, the darkest hour is just before the dawn. So I wish you a safe new year and look forward to us all enjoying a glorious sunrise at some point in 2021. Happy New Year.
Thank you.